All right, people, it's March 31st, 3:18 p.m., 2022. It would look like we have been churning in the cosmic ocean for like 1,000 years now. And this new heavens and this new earth has everything to do with things being reborn after this cycle ends. Maybe this did have something to do with atonement. For killing the man on Calvary. Okay? I'm thinking, people, we are still in the underworld. Jesus was battling in hell. There is underworld deities that were created for this area, I believe. And the only way that you can truly escape is if you have a soul resonance with your ancestors, or you follow a prescribed method that's been laid down from the past, because it's also telling you to seek out the old ways or the past way to make your path straight. So whomever has been coding off of me, hijacking my information, posing as me as a double ganger, because I remember this movie called Duplicate, and the only way that they can get into the multiverse was through these solstices and these equinoxes. There's a movie called Duplicate that show you that there's certain buildings here in this on this planetarium that actually is housing portals or housing entryways to breach into the multiverse. I found that out too. Yeah. So, what were they saying? We live in the past, present, and future at the same time. Excuse me, I had to belch. But that's the only way. Because this is actually a platform. I don't know about this flat earth theory. I believe it's a firmament. And it really is like a bioorganic ship with a dome over it. If you're above these skies, that's what it's going to look like. And it's not actually... it's not actually moving. They have simulated planets to seem like it's moving around it. But I wonder whose joke was this to do this to people? Or was it just the fact that because the skies fell, they had to preserve this planet so that life could still exist after the skies fell in their ancient battle? And a lot of these giants came from a different time period, a different dimension. Now, we do have Nephilim, and then we do have giants that were actually couples. And that makes me think of the inner earth theory, that they really did go in Antarctica, and they really did see that things were larger than life. That would have been Agartha. Or Shambhala, wouldn't it have been? So, Jody's not about to let anyone dictate to her about this surreality or this so-called illusion. Jody will conquer this Maya. And in conquering Maya, or the Mahamaya, I would have to be conquering myself. So you better know that your battles are personal with yourself. And don't take your bullshit out on other people. I bet y'all won't be practicing MKUltra mind control no more on nobody else. Because that's how people's heavens gets destroyed. And that's how people's subtle bodies get destroyed.